A very good morning to everyone joining us for this vital service this morning, brought to you via the amazing technological gifts God has bestowed on some of his people. My name is Rosalind Amey, and I am a reader in the St. Alan Benefice of West Cumbria. Today is Sunday, August the 30th, and change is in the air. Firstly, we've reached the end of the summer holidays, and are only a few days away from the start of not just a new school term, but a new school year. Always a time of excitement mixed with apprehension, but so much more so this year. Secondly, autumn beckons with its changing leaves, the change of focus to our days, and the changeover in our wardrobes from lighter to warmer clothes. Thirdly, and for many of us most importantly, the imminent change from digital to real services, getting back into church, picking up the Sunday routines some of us have not experienced since March. Yes, it's normally all change at this time of year, but because of Corona, this year's change will be familiarly different, and we can approach it with trepidation or with eager anticipation or somewhere in between. So the theme of this morning's service is facing change. And we're going to begin with a hymn which reminds us of God's faithfulness no matter what the circumstances. It's in heavenly love abiding, no change my heart shall fear. Just sung, or we've certainly heard, Anna Letitia Waring's great words about always trusting God. Do we always do it? No. We let him down in so many ways. So now's our opportunity to tell him we're sorry for everything that we wish we had or hadn't done, receive his forgiveness, and promise to try to change for the better. Lord, we confess before you our littleness, our meanness, and our sin. We have not always followed after Christ. We have not always given love to the loveless and the lost, and we are sorry. We ask you now to change our lives, that we may take your light into dark places. Please help and uphold us when the temptations of the world press upon us, and when the frustrations of coronavirus and when the frustrations of coronavirus restrictions anger and frustrate us. Please show us what to do to live lives that truly reflect your love, and please strengthen us when hope and faith flicker in our current situation and fail within us. Amen. And so may Almighty God, who knows every thought of our minds and hearts, forgive us what is past and change us to become more like him every minute. Amen. We now come to our Bible reading, read for us by Tori, a few verses from Psalm 105.
Our reading is taken from Psalms 105, verses 1 to 5. Give thanks to the Lord and proclaim his greatness. Let the whole world know what he has done. Sing to him. Yes, sing his praises. Tell everyone about his wonderful deeds. Exult in his holy name. Rejoice, you who worship the Lord. Search for the Lord and for his strength, and continually seek him. Remember the wonders he has performed, his miracles, and the rulings that he has given. Thanks be for his word and message given for us today. Amen.
Thank you, Toy. Psalm 105, verses 1 to 5. An odd reading, you may think, but it appeared somewhere in a selection of readings appointed for today and jumped, metaphorically jumped, of course, and jumped out at me because of its numerous reasons why we should praise the Lord. Some things never change, and our call to praise God in spite of everything is one of them. So let's do a quick analysis of these verses and see what each one says to our changing COVID situation. There are eight key words in these five verses, namely thanks, call, praise, look, glory, seek, tell, remember, sing, and rejoice. Actually, that's 10. I never was any good at maths. So I made up a mnemonic, or a memory jogger, to help us remember them. As mnemonics go, I don't think it will be remembered down the centuries. Think about that. But all being well, it will appear on your screens at the end of the service. So here goes. We have TCP. Thank, call, praise. And TCP heals our hurts. We have L, little o, G, S. Look, glory, seek. We log in to connect to God, as in logging on to a computer. T, R, S, R. Tell, remember, sing, rejoice. And that is incomplete treasure. Add four vowels, you have treasure, but complete treasure is only found in heaven. And how does all this relate to our theme of change? I'll try to tell you. Thank in verse one. We're frequently not very good at showing gratitude, whether to God or anyone else. Give thanks are the first two words of Psalm 105. How about changing our focus and making thanks one of the first things we do each day? If we have a roof over our heads, food on our table, enough money to live on, and people who love us, we are among the richest people in the world. Ignore COVID for a moment and thank God daily for his blessings. Call, also in verse 1. Instead of complaining about the things we can no longer do or the things we are now legally obliged to do, let's change our perspective and call upon God to help us accept them graciously and see us through. Praise in verse 2. Again, instead of complaining, how about focusing on the things we can praise God for, especially if we have escaped the virus? Look and seek in verses 3 and 4. In Eleanor H. Porter's story of Pollyanna, Pollyanna was taught to play the glad game, in which she looked for something to be glad about in every unwished for situation. How much would it change our outlook on life if we were to do the same? Glory in verse 3. I couldn't help thinking here of the chorus of Helen Lemmel's hymn, O Soul, Art Thou Weary and Troubled. And the chorus goes, turn your eyes upon Jesus, look full in his wonderful face, and the things of earth will grow strangely dim in the light of his glory and grace. Tell in verse 2. We're often quick to tell people how we are and what has happened to us. Wouldn't it make a change to tell them about the God who is walking through this pandemic with us? Remember, verse 5. Things may not appear very good now, but looking back on our lives, there must have been times when God was obviously at work, and he hasn't changed. Sing twice in verse 2. Singing is what we often do when we're happy. Well, if we change the word happy to content, I think we should all have something to sing about. Coronavirus isn't exactly a happy clappy subject, but as St. Paul wrote to the Philippians, that with Christ in his life, he was content in all things. So surely all Christians have something to sing about. And finally, rejoice in verse 3. Let the hearts of those who seek the Lord rejoice, says verse 3. Rejoice, to feel or show great joy, says the Oxford in English Dictionary. Rejoice in the Lord always, wrote St. Paul and a contemporary chorus writer. I could go on, but I won't. And that is something you may wish to rejoice about. And so we turn to a time of intercession, a time of prayer, asking God to help us, not just this week, but through our lives. We start with a prayer which is very relevant for this time. Lord, help us to accept the challenge of coronavirus, to protect the healthy, calm the fearful, to offer courage to those in pain, to embrace the dying as they flow into love's unendingness, to console the bereaved, to support all those who attempt to care for the sick and dying. Enable us to offer our energies, our imaginations, and our trusting in the mysteries of love, to be united with and through one another in liberating each other from fear of disease. We offer these thoughts and prayers in the mystery of the loving that can and does bear all our woundings, whatever their source, through the spirit of love's concern for each and every person. And we know that time changes things, that God is unchanging. And so we pray, through every minute of this day, be with us, Lord. Through every day of all this week, be with us, Lord. Through every week of all this year, be with us, Lord. Through all the years of all this life, be with us, Lord. So shall the days and weeks and years be grafted into you, and all draw with sweet accord unto your fullness, Lord. That so, when time is passing, by grace, we may at last be with you, Lord, the unchanging one. And as we try to remember all that God has done for us, and that God is unchanging, and that he calls us to do his work for him here in Cumbria, we pray the God for all prayer. And if you know this, please join in at home. God for all, you reached out to the world in your Son, Jesus Christ. Help us to reach out in faith and love and witness to all. God for all, you send your Holy Spirit to empower and gift your church. By your Spirit, help us grow in unity, grow as followers of Jesus Christ, and grow your kingdom in Cumbria and in this world. Amen. And drawing all our prayers and praises and thoughts together, we say the prayer that Jesus taught us using the traditional words. Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. For thine is the kingdom, the power, and the glory, for ever and ever. Amen. Have another hymn now. I will go in the strength of the Lord. Very encouraging words as we leave our computer screens or our television screens and head back into our normal life.
Thank you.
and so. Let nothing disturb us. Let nothing frighten us. All things are passing. God never changes. Patience obtains all things. They who have God find they lack nothing. Alone God suffices. May the blessing of God Almighty, the Father, the Son, and the Holy Spirit be with us all, with those whom we love and those who love us, this day and forever. Amen.
I've just finished editing Rosalind's service together, putting in the hymns and doing all the bits and pieces that hopefully make it look at least half decent. And I thought I'd just take a moment now before I finally upload it to YouTube, ready for Sunday, to stop and say a thank you to an awful lot of people. You know, way back in the end of the winter in March time, when we were suddenly hit with lockdown, we wondered what we were going to do about church, how we were going to stay together, how were we going to worship. And we came up with this idea of viral church, a service shared via the internet, but using familiar faces to be able to come and lead worship and pray and sing. And it started in an awfully simple way, but has grown and grown. And so now I owe thanks to far too many people to name, but you know who you are. All of those who have contributed in recent months to these viral church services. But now, as lockdown is coming to an end, it's time to draw the veil on viral church. We're all starting to go back to our buildings. People are going back to work and don't have as much time to help us out as they did. And so this is the very last viral church. But that doesn't mean it's all ending. We do know that these services have been really appreciated by some of the people who have been housebound or aren't able to get to church for all sorts of reasons. And so we're looking at new and exciting things to come. I'm working on a project called Church at Home, which will be more aimed specifically at those who can't get to church. So still some worship and prayer and a brief thought, but hopefully bringing you news and interviews and stuff like that to keep you up to date with what's going on around the circuit. And we're also exploring the possibility of broadcasting a service live each Sunday, initially certainly from the church at Keswick. We're having the equipment installed over the next few weeks, though for some reason, strangely, there's been a run on streaming equipment recently, so there may be a little bit of a delay. But we hope that quite soon we'll be able to bring you live worship every Sunday morning from Keswick Methodist Church. But in the meantime, as I've said, thank you to those who have taken part, and thank you to you who have joined us each week, and for the lovely comments that we've all received. And do keep an eye on our channel. We're not going off air. There will be new stuff going up soon and regularly. But in the meantime, thank you.